Mike, hello.
What's going on, everybody? My name is Crash Prendo, and today I want to talk to you about one of my favorite lenses, the 50mm. But before we start the video, could you please do me a favor and hit the like button? It really helps out my channel and my videos, and hit that subscribe button if you want to see more content from me. Anyways, let's roll the intro and start this video. Alright, to give you a little bit of context on how I came to my opinion on the 50mm. So, when I started off in photography a few years ago, I wanted to get involved in portraits, but when you buy a standard Canon camera, it comes with a standard lens, which was a 18x55mm or a 55x250mm. And the problem with that is the lenses aren't that great. You get a simple lens that doesn't shoot well. So I wanted to get a better lens, but also it was cost effective. So let's start off with reason number one, prices. So the price of the 50mm, my first one, was $125. It came with a 1.8 aperture, which is good for what I wanted to do. It really gave me that focal length that I needed. And for the price that it was cheaper than buying something like a 70 to 200 millimeter with quality glass, and it was a good investment. I had that lens for up to a year and a half before I accidentally broke it, so I upgraded to the $350 one, which was a 50mm 1.4 aperture. And now let's talk about the second reason why you need to pick one of these up. Aperture. So the aperture is the amount of eye that opens and closes for the lens. Normally with a 50mm, you will have a higher aperture, and because of that higher aperture, it's better to be able to shoot in low light, which is great for photographers who like shooting near sunset or during the nighttime or when you're in indoor spaces. Also, because you're shooting with a higher aperture, you're gonna be able to get a stronger and sharper focus on your figure that you're trying to take a picture of, your subject, and everything in the background will be blurry and out of focus, which is great because it brings all of the attention to your figure. And that brings me to number three as to why you should pick one up. It is a prime lens, a fixed lens. So you're thinking to yourself, well, I have a 18x55 that can zoom in up to 50, why would I stay with that? Well, the problem is when you're shooting with a zoom lens, you won't have a consistent and accurate and a larger aperture. So because of that, you lose out on shooting later at night, sharper focus. And that was the problem that I had when I had my 18-55. It wouldn't go any lower than 3.5 on 18mm, or when it was on 55, 4 to 4.5, which was very hard for me to take good, crisp photos. And another thing is, the glass is a lot better, so you don't get that lens distortion when you're zooming in, which you would when you have a zoom lens. That's not something that happens on a prime lens. All right, to run through all the reasons why, again, you should pick up the 50mm. One, pricing, it's a very good price when you're starting off and if you're a budgeted photographer who wants to take better quality photos. Two, dose, aperture. So the aperture is great, again, for when you want to take a nice, sharp, clean photo of your subject and you want that nice bokeh background. Thrice, it's a prime lens, which is good for its own reasons, which unless you have a larger budget to get a better lens, this is a great lens for what you want to work with. It's a great starter lens. Anyways, that's everything I have for this video. Again, if you please could, hit that like button. And also, if you really like my content, smash that subscribe button so that way you can see more content of mine. Let's get this wrapped up and I will see you all on the flip side. Bring it back, bring it back. Oh.